Today on BRStv Investigates, it's time to look at an LED option which strays pretty far away from the module format that we've been reviewing over the last few months with the Orphek Atlantik V4 LED panel. Hi, I'm Ryan, your host of BRStv Investigates, a weekly YouTube series which explores popular reefing theories, products, methods, what the manuals are missing, with a focus on putting them to the test, and then we give away much of what we test at the end. This week we're giving away a free $900 Atlantik Orphek V4. I'm going to say right off the bat, I'm excited to see how this light performs because it's very different than anything else that we've put to the test. Almost all of the other solutions have been smaller modules that incorporate small clusters or pucks of LEDs. While those clusters and compact sources of light work well for LPS and even some mixed tanks, SPS dominant tank owners often have spacing these modules really close to each other, or adding other technologies like T5s in a hybrid approach to create more diffused, even coverage and avoid undesirable shadowing that single points of light create. The Atlantik V4 spreads out a total of 78 different LEDs in 14 different spectrums to create a light source which is 24 inches long and almost 9.5 inches wide. It's pretty reasonable to assume that this wide array of LEDs is going to produce a much more diffuse source of light and much more difficult to shadow. I think that's why it's becoming increasingly popular with SPS tank owners. Also note that the 14 different spectrums create the widest blue spectrum that we've seen from any LED fixture by a pretty large margin, and even exceeds popular T5 bulb performance in the deep blue or violet range. I think a lot of reefers are going to find this lighting option pretty interesting. Diving right into it, we're going to look at coral health factors with providing adequate PAR, how that PAR is distributed, and spectrum. Our focus is always on SPS and higher demand corals when evaluating PAR because almost any common reef tank lighting can provide the lower PAR required for LPS and lower light corals. That range for SPS that we're shooting for is in the 250 to 350 range in as much of the tank as possible. That range coming from our episode called How Much PAR for SPS, which dives into that question from all angles. Our first PAR test will be on the 24-inch cube, taking a depth of 6, 12, and 18 inches deep in the tank. The Orphek is designed to be mounted at a height of 16 inches above the tank, but since this light is 24 inches wide, at that height, we might get some spill into the room. So we're going to show you what it looks like at a mounting height of 12, 14, and 16 inches high. We're going to start by running 100% on all four channels. I'll say there's one thing that's a bit different about the Orphek, and that's the light actually visually looks pretty good with all channels on max, which is not the case with almost any other LED option out there. The LED selection is balanced, and I can actually see reefers running them this way. So looking at the first set of PAR numbers at a mounting height of 12 inches and a depth of 6 inches, we're seeing 553 PAR in the center, 413 in the middle ring, and 271 in the outside edges. The PAR distribution follows the shape of the light, and from left to right, there's only 133 PAR difference from the outside edge of the tank to the center. Not surprisingly, this is almost identical performance to the 8-bulb ATI Sun Power we tested. The Sun Power is mounted lower, but getting similar even spread using LEDs is pretty impressive. I think this goes without saying that this is the best shallow depth performance that we've seen from any LED module we've tested in the 24-inch cube. Moving down to 12 inches deep in the tank, the center of the tank has an average of 380 PAR, 331 in the middle ring, and 310 in the outer ring, which is also ultra even. So I don't think anyone would be surprised to see more of the same at a depth of 18 inches in the tank, with 277 in the center, 292 in the middle ring, and 313 in the outer ring, with the glass redistributing the light a bit. Overall, top to bottom, really awesome light intensity and distribution. Now that was with all channels at 100%. The team here played around with the light a bit and checked it out on various tanks and took spectrum measurements. Ultimately, we came to the consensus that the spectrum mix that we would likely start with would be around 70% on channel 1, which is the whitest of the channels, 100% on channel 2, which is the blue channel, 100% on channel 3, which is a UV and violet channel, and 40%, which includes a variety of spectrums, including red, infrared, UV, and some blue. So we tested light again at these settings and at the same mounting height of 12 inches. At a depth of 6 inches, we saw 461 in the center, 368 in the middle ring, and 237 on the outside edges. Similar performance at a depth of 12 inches with 331 in the center, 293 in the middle ring, and 276 on the outer edge. And down at 18 inches deep in the tank, we're looking at 238, 255, and 275 respectively. Overall, 108 points, the average PAR was just 12% lower using the custom program we created. This is because the channel 1 was only slightly turned down and channel 4 is lower PAR LEDs. I think this mix of LEDs included on the fixture by default pretty closely matches what reefers will want to use. And unlike some of the other options out there, you won't have to turn down half or more of the channels to 20 or 30%. So from here on out, all the PAR tests will be with our custom spectrum mix, but no, you could get 12% or so more PAR if you wanted to run everything at max. As I mentioned earlier, we also tested a mounting height of 14 and 16 inches off the water. At a height of 14 inches and a depth of 6 inches in the water, the spread got even better with 397 in the center of the tank, 333 in the middle ring, and an average of 235 at the outer edges. Solid performance at the hardest area of the tank to evenly illuminate. At a depth of 12 inches, we're looking at 282 in the center, 262 in the middle ring, 275 in the outside edges. Almost every PAR reading in the 250 to 300 range, which is awesome. Down at 18 inches deep, we're looking at 207 in the center, 230 in the middle ring, and 262 on the outside edges. You can see the glass is reflecting light off the front of the tank. Same thing would happen in the back here, but the back is painted black to simulate standard tank installs. Moving the light up to 16 inches, which is the suggested mounting height, I don't think that many of you will be surprised to see the spread at the very top of the tank now looks similar to the bottom of the tank with some of the higher PAR modular options. At a depth of 6 inches, we're seeing 343 in the center, 296 in the middle ring, and 277 on the outer edges. At a depth of 12 inches, 243, 232, and 261 respectively. And down at 18 inches deep in the tank, we're looking at 182 in the center, 208 in the middle ring, and 247 on the outer edges. Overall, solid performance. If you're running an SPS tank, any of these mounting options will probably work. It will depend on your aquascape to some degree. I think I would personally select a 13 to 14 inch mounting height for an SPS tank in a cube like this. So we're going to take two additional looks at this on a 4 foot 120 gallon tank. We're going to look at this from two angles. Two Orphek Atlantiks mounted side by side, which basically creates one large panel that covers the entire tank, as well as a single Orphek mounted at 16 inches, which they claim can illuminate an entire 4 foot tank. We're going to start with that single Orphek Atlantik mounted 16 inches above the tank with our custom program. At a depth of 6 inches, we're seeing 281 in the center, 211 in the middle, and 121 on the outside edges. This is pretty solid spread for a single light attempting to cover a 4 foot wide area at this very shallow depth. Looking at a depth of 12 inches, we're seeing an average of 210 in the center, 169 in the middle ring, and 171 on the outer edges. This isn't super high PAR, but there are areas near or above that desired 250. Down at the bottom of the tank, or 18 inches deep, we're looking at 161 in the center, 150 in the middle ring, and 152 on the outside edges. Overall, I think I'd call the single panel a really solid choice for a mixed reef with SPS predominantly in the upper half or center of the tank, and LPS coral spread throughout the rest of the aquascape. Now looking at two of the Orphek Atlantik panels mounted 12 inches off the tank, side by side on the 4 foot 120, starting at a depth of 6 inches. Not surprisingly, we're seeing that same awesome spread with 489 in the center, 399 in the middle, and 225 on the outside edges. I feel like I have to reiterate that the only other time that we've seen this type of even distribution of light at this depth is with an 8-bulb T5 fixture, so these larger panels are in the same neighborhood of meeting or exceeding the performance of the older standards of reef tank lighting on a distribution front. Looking at 12 inches deep in the tank, we're seeing 374 in the center, 330 in the middle ring, and 272 on the outside edges of the tank. And at the bottom, or 18 inches deep, we're looking at 295, 279, and 297 respectively. I don't think there's any question here, this is more than enough PAR, and this type of even distribution of light with LED-only options has only been achieved with using somewhere between 4 and 8 modules with other popular brands. Overall, I think SPS owners looking for even spread similar to older technologies are going to find this to be significantly less expensive. So moving on to providing proper spectrum to the corals, most of the LED modules out there have just a handful of different LEDs included in the module. The Atlantik V4 actually includes 14 different LED types, each with unique spectrum offerings. Net result is the widest spectrum offering of any LED that we've tested, and again, potentially exceeding older technologies. You can see the UV to blue spectrum ranges from below the 380s all the way up to the 480s and has strong representation at every major nanometer band. That's because rather than just having white, blue, and deep blue LEDs, they're including 20K, 5K, 525 nanometer, 500, 470, 460, 440, 540, 410, 420, 380, 590 red, and even an 850 infrared LED, which I don't believe any other major LED light has even attempted. Just to give you an idea of how wide the spectrum is, we overlaid the spectrum offerings of other top LED options we've tested on top of one of the historical gold standards of reef tank lighting, the ATI Blue Plus T5 bulb spectrum. You can see the Orphek is actually exceeding the UV to blue spectrum peak on almost all fronts. I don't think there's any question here as to if this light is capable of offering spectrums important to corals, because it's actually exceeding every option that we've tested on that front. Now looking at spectrum blending, which is looking at how the light blends all of those individual LED spectrums into one uniform spectrum, this is an area where I personally anticipate less than perfect performance, just due to how the various LEDs are spread out over the entire panel. We always look at this first from a static perspective, which is mounting the light 19 inches over the sensor and taking 9 measurement points on a 24-inch grid to see if there's any significant variance from the center to the outside edges of the tanks in terms of spectrum. In this case, you can see there are some variants, primarily in the mix and distribution of the blue peak. This is pretty typical of LEDs that use individual lenses for each of the LEDs, and in this case, there are a pair of LEDs under each lens, and the spectrum isn't blending perfectly. We did decide to test this light 8 inches higher than other options as well, because Orphek does suggest a mounting height of 8 inches higher than most. You can see that absolutely improved performance and made it very similar blending performance to other LED options. We also look at this from a dynamic spectrum blending angle as to how well the lighting source interacts with the surface of the water, which tends to refract the individual LED spectrums around the tank if they're not diffused or packed together under a single lens. And then we mount the lights at a standard mounting height specific to that light. In this case, we elected 12 inches because that's actually where most of the team said they would mount it on a cube like this. This ended up being better than anticipated performance, and there were only subtle shifts in spectrum between all 9 measurement points, and actually performed better than a vast majority of the LED modules that we've tested. I can only guess that spreading the LEDs out over a wide area only improves blending once the surface ripples and refractive properties are factored in. So looking at all 3 coral health factors, PAR, PAR distribution, and spectrum, I'm going to say this light can grow corals, and in fact on many fronts, it appears to have some of the best performance metrics that we have tested. Moving on to visual appeal and how the light makes the corals and tank look with color pop, contrast, and sense of depth, shimmer, dimming, lunar lights, and physical appeal, because right after coral health, I think the main thing here is we want the tank and corals to look awesome. That's kind of the whole purpose of building and maintaining a reef tank in our home. In relation to coral color pop, having the widest blue spectrum and in general the total 14 different LED spectrum offerings provides the ability to likely get the best coral color pop out there. Some LEDs might be close, but I don't think anything is going to beat this light. There's no question, this light is going to make the corals, fish, and aquascape look awesome. There's one note here that I want to reiterate again. This is one of the only options out there that actually looks good with all of the individual channels and spectrums at 100%, meaning the LED mix they selected is balanced and doesn't just produce an appealing color, but also in PAR ranges usable by most reefers. This just isn't the same waste or cost inefficiency that comes with buying a module that needs half of the LEDs turned down by half to be usable. In fact, our wholesale manager, Nick, told me he would run them all at 100% because the look is pretty awesome. However, the rest of us liked it a little bit bluer with that custom option setting that we made, but the difference is pretty subtle. In relation to contrast and sense of depth, even though the light is providing that blanket of wide-angle, hard-to-shadow light, very similar to T5s, however, unlike T5s, with that flat, soft-looking image, this image is sharp, contrasty, and visually interesting. Similar to that with shimmer, the fixture has the same type of hard edge shimmer that no diffuse LEDs are known for, but is significantly better than most LED options. The nature of having that many individual LEDs spread over a wide area is it creates such a large quantity of shimmer lines that they naturally mute each other. I think this is probably one of the better LED options out there in terms of shimmer. In terms of dimming, there are 4 dimming channels, first of which of what I would call white, but includes a full spectrum option of what looks like covers almost everything from blue to fairly deep red. The second channel is predominantly blue spectrum, followed by UV and violet channel, and the 4th channel is what I would refer to as the red channel, but it's a mix of blue, yellow, orange, red, and infrared. Combined with blue, adjusting this tends to give the visual perception of adding purple or magenta to the tank. all of which are adjustable from 1 to 100%, which means they're not just capable of almost any program you might like, but they're also dimmable all the way down for use for moonlights or lunar cycles that most of us appreciate for nighttime viewing. Lastly, as a physical appeal of the light itself, I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10 here. It's low profile and the acrylic build looks sharp. However, I do wish the hanging kit was a bit lower profile, and it seems like there has to be a better way to hide the antenna than on the side of the fixture. I also say one of my concerns about any fixture that's designed to be hung over a foot above the tank is the amount of spill into the room or if it will blind me from a sitting position. In this case, there's an acrylic shroud that extends beyond the spherical or HEI type lenses that seems to redirect most of the light downward or at least preventing it from spilling over into the room or my face. This implementation seems to work really well. And the last component, available features with mounting options, on and off-board controllability, intuitive modes, controller compatibility, build quality, and quiet operation. Starting with mounting options, it comes with a hanging kit and is designed to be hung from the ceiling or wall brackets like those from Giesemann. There are lots of reefers out there who have retroed other lighting brand brackets and tank mounts, and there's obviously DIY options like aluminum 8020. There's no onboard controllability, so you have to use your app with your phone or tablet, which is available for both Android and Apple products. You will need a single Orphek gateway, just plugs into your router, type in the box's code into your app, and you're set to go. One gateway will run more Atlantiks than most people would ever consider buying. Once you're in, setting up the light is super easy, and there are some intuitive modes already set up for you based on slow acclimation, coral growth, coral color, color and growth, frag systems, and LPS and soft corals. So that just giving you the keys to the Spectrum Kingdom and leaving to your own devices, there's help here to help you set it up properly to your goals. Right now, there's no controller compatibility, so it isn't controllable via popular controllers like the Apex. I can't say with 100% certainty that it is possible, but I think it's likely they can make the Atlantik Apex ready if they wanted. So if you'd like to see that, I would absolutely encourage you to share that in today's comments, Reef to Reef thread, or even better, send the Orphek team an email saying you'd like to see these things controller ready. In terms of build quality, the light comes in at 17 pounds and has a solid heat sink, uses some of the best drivers out there with an external Meanwell driver, as well as a fan-driven cooling system for the large heat sink, which runs whisper quiet. So to wrap this up, I think the Orphek Atlantik V4 did pretty awesome on most of our tests and important components that we look at. In fact, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say, if I were going to do a 100% LED install on an SPS tank, I think this would be my first choice because it's going to provide the best coverage, color, and spread, and has one of the lowest costs per LED of any of the best options out there. Achieving the same performance with smaller modules would likely mean buying many to produce a grid-like coverage and potentially much more expensive. So the best part of the day is we're giving away one of these Atlantiks for free this week, so click that link that just showed up or head on over to the site and click on Sales and Deals, then Free Stuff, and sign up. The Reef to Reef community has been asking us to review the Orphek Atlantik for a long time, so I'm really pretty interested to see what that community has to say about the light after seeing today's data. If you're interested or want to share your thoughts, click on the link in the description down below and head on over to their site. Just as an FYI, Randy and his partner editor Carlos are taking some much-needed vacation next week, so you won't see them, but they will be back the following week. As always, if you like what we're doing here and want to see more, give us a quick thumbs up and let us know, and subscribe because we release new reefing videos all week long.